Welcome to an example where we're given the general equation of a circle and we're asked to write the equation in standard form and then give the center and radius of the circle. We know this equation is a circle because the x squared and y squared terms have the same coefficient. In this case, they're both 1. So we want to write the equation here in general form into standard form, which is given here below. The quantity x minus h squared plus the quantity y minus k squared equals r squared is the standard form of a circle, where in this form, the center has coordinates h, k, and the radius is equal to r. So the quantity x minus h squared means we have a perfect square trinomial in terms of x, and the quantity y minus k squared means we have a perfect square trinomial in terms of y as well. And we'll have to form these perfect square trinomials using the general form of our equation. So we'll have x squared minus 6x plus some constant that would make this a perfect square trinomial, plus y squared plus 8y plus a constant that will make this a perfect square trinomial. Let's go ahead and move the constant 5 to the right side, so we'll have equals negative 5, but because we're going to be adding two constants on the left, let's go ahead and put plus blank to remind us to add the constant to both sides of the equation. And now to find the constant to make this a perfect square trinomial, we're going to take half of the coefficient of x and square it. So if we take negative 6 and divide by 2 and square it, this value will make this a perfect square trinomial. Well, negative 6 divided by 2 is negative 3. Negative 3 squared is equal to positive 9. So we're going to add 9 here and also add 9 to the right side of the equation. And now to make the second trinomial a perfect square, we'll take half of 8 and square it, which would be 4 squared, which is equal to 16. So we'll add 16 here, and we'll add 16 to the right as well. Now we'll factor the x part and the y part separately, and these should be perfect square trinomials. So we'll show all the work in this example. This will factor into two binomials, where we have x and x. The factors of positive 9 that add to negative 6 would be negative 3 and negative 3, so we have x minus 3 and x minus 3. Notice how we can rewrite this as the quantity x minus 3 squared, which we'll do in the next step. Plus, the trinomial in terms of y will factor into two binomials. So we'll have y and y. And now the factors of positive 16 that add to positive 8 are 4 and 4, so we'll have y plus 4 and y plus 4. Notice on the right we have negative 5 plus 9, that's 4, plus 16 is 20. And now we can write this in standard form. We have the quantity x minus 3 squared plus the quantity y plus 4 squared equals 20. Now that we have this in standard form, we can find the center and the radius. Because we have the quantity x minus 3 squared, the x coordinate is positive 3. And because we have the quantity y plus 4 squared, the y coordinate is negative 4. So notice how the signs of these coordinates are the opposite of what we see here because of the standard form of a circle. For y plus 4, we could write this as y minus negative 4, but it's easier just to remember that the signs of these coordinates are the opposite of what we see here. If we have x minus 3, the x coordinate is positive 3. If we have y plus 4, the y coordinate is negative 4. And then to find the radius, the right side of this equation in standard form is equal to r squared, which means r squared is equal to 20. This represents a length, so we can take the principal square root or positive square root of both sides to find r. So we'd have r equals square root 20, which does simplify. 20 is equal to 4 times 5, so we can write r is equal to 2 square root 5. Or if we want a decimal approximation, this would be approximately 4.47. So we'll go ahead and give the exact value. That would be 2 square root 5 units. But in order to graph this circle by hand, the decimal approximation would probably be more useful. So again, this question asks us for the standard form of the circle and the coordinates of the center and the length of the radius. So this information is right here. And we'll go ahead and finish by graphing this. Here's our circle. Notice the center has coordinates 3, negative 4. If we sketch the segment from the center to a point on the circle, let's say this segment here, this would be the radius, which we found to be 2 square root 5, or approximately 4.47. Okay, hope you found this explanation helpful.